Hi, welcome to an Inventor 2019 video tutorial. I want to do that bicycle saddle exercise now in Inventor. And as usual, Inventor really lacks some decent tools for that, but let's have fun with Inventor. Anyway, first I want to create some planes. So let's go for a plane with a distance to that one, 30. Another one at 250. And the last one in that direction at 280. Then one with a distance to this one with 60. I could add a work point at, so go for a point, and that would be an intersection of this one with that one and the XY plane. So I've got a nice little work point over here. Let's start with a sketch on the XZ plane. This will be a spline which starts here, goes up over here, goes up, goes down, and should end on that point somehow. But you can use that plane, just project that plane into your sketch like this. Okay, now that one should be on this one, and those two points should be horizontal aligned. Let's add some dimensions. This would be 14.5. This might be 18. This might be 70, and the last one might be 60. Then the distance here, so that's kind of odd. I can't go for a horizontal dimension, and I always thought it's in the right context menu, but that's version 19 and maybe something's different. Let's see, I want to go from this one to that one. Really? That's really odd. So let's try it from that one. So that distance should be 30. This distance should be 70. Let's try it now. This distance should really, that's kind of odd. Inventor always surprises with something new and different. So let's go from this one to that one. This might be 240, and the last one, no, not an angle, to this point should be 280 minus 11. Let's activate the handle That handle should be vertical aligned. Activate that handle over here as well. This one should be vertical aligned. And that one right here might be horizontal aligned. Yeah. Finish that sketch, and the one plane, that one, that's the second one, should be at 230. Okay, next sketch is on the XY plane. This will be another spline, but first I should project that work point into my sketch. Then go for a spline. One, two, three, four, and end here. Okay. Now let's add some dimensions. This will be 20. This might be 93. This might be 200. That might be 260. Next, I want distance from that point to this point. I want to go from this one to that one, and this will be 27. This might be 35, and I just noticed I didn't switch off that, so that's the problem. I didn't check on this one. It's a new installation and I forgot to deactivate something. I will show it to you. Okay, so now that one. From here to that line, this should be 63, and this might be 70. Or 75. Yeah. And I might activate the handle here. And adjust it a little bit. Maybe here as well. Like this. And okay. So I was talking about that option here in the sketch. Don't auto project and edges during curve creation. Yes, and okay. Another sketch on the same plane. Again, project that working point Do a sketch. Another spline. Goes down, up, over here, over there, and ends right there. Okay. So this might be 4. This might be 5. This distance might be 15. And that one might be 38. Then I want a distance from that point to this point. This might be 46. This might be 140. That one might be 210, and the last one might be 245. Finish that sketch and hide those dimensions. Okay, and I could hide the planes as well. Nice. Now I need sort of, it's called an intersection curve in Inventor, so I'll go for a 3D sketch. And I want an intersection curve between this one and that one. Confirm. Very nice. Finish that sketch, and now I can hide sketch 4 and sketch 1. Then I need some work points. Let's go for a point. This would be intersection of the curve with that plane, and again plane and this curve, again plane that curve, not plane but a point, sorry, point curve, point. And they used to be better visible, definitely. Next, a 2D sketch on that plane. Let's see where the points are. Let's project them. Work point 2, work point 3. Then a spline, which starts here, goes to this one, confirm. Activate the handle, make this one, hopefully it's horizontal, no, that's another oddity, let's undo this, it's sort of mixed, so this one should be vertical in this view, and then that handle would be horizontal in this view. Finish that sketch. Another sketch on that plane. Again, project the work points, point 4, point 5. Make a spline. activate the handles. This one should be vertical in this view, and that one should be horizontal in that view. Great, finish that sketch. Let's see, I will need an extrude with that sketch, that's okay. And I will go for a ruled surface here. And the vector would be the y-axis, yes, and okay. But the other way around. So let's edit this one like that. Okay. Let's do a loft from this edge to that edge. Rail 1 would be this one. Rail 2 would be that one. And make it tangents and tangency as condition. And confirm. Now I want to trim with that tool this one away, apply, and again with that tool this should go away, and okay. I want to patch these, therefore I need sort of a closed surface. Let's see, we can do a loft from this edge to that edge, make it tangent to both surfaces, okay. Same over here. Loft at edge condition tangent and tangent to the face, and okay. Then stitch it together. So this one, that one, this one, this one, and that one. Apply, done. And now I can patch these holes. So go for a patch here. Make it tangent to all faces and edges. Apply. And the same over here. Tangent. Okay. Very nice. Let's see which bodies we have. We have one body, second body, that's a complete body. Is there the loft? Still the loft. That's this one, that's the one. Let's show this one and hide the complete one. Now let's stitch those. 1, 2, 3. Apply, and done. And then mirror it. So go for mirror. I want to mirror this one. Mirror plane should be the XY plane. And okay. Then stitch this one to that one. Apply, and done. Make it like this, and I'm done. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook cat fan page. Would be very nice of you. I want to get more likes and subscriptions over there as well. So thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.